thought, since coffee has been keeping me sane over these past few months, I thought why not do coffee talks on my channel from now on, in which I just sit back and talk about things that I like or stuff like that. But yeah, cheers. And for those of you who are new to my channel, since I've been absent from my channel now, let me just make a quick introduction. I am Sonali. I call myself the Melodramatic Bookworm because I am melodramatic. And I make book-related videos on this channel and occasionally a few travel-related and a few movie-related videos as well. So if you like my content, then please stay and share and spread the word so that more people can join the Melodramatic family and we all can have fun while discussing books and creating melodrama or something. Hey guys, this is Sonali, the Melodramatic Bookworm. Welcome back to my channel. It feels so good to say that again because I have been on a break for the past few months. I was not able to take the pressure of posting. BookTube had become just one more thing to do on my long list of to-do items, so I thought rather than risk burnout, which I think I already had at that point in time, but rather than risk losing my mind completely, I thought I'd take a step back from BookTube. And I feel like it has done me a lot of good over the past couple of 2 or 3 months that I have been absent from this platform, and I feel better, I feel refreshed, and I feel like I can put forward a lot more content right now, a lot more content that I enjoy making, and I hope that you will like it as well. The thing about BookTube is that it needs a lot of energy, and it's not only while filming the video, it takes a lot of energy to conceptualize a video, to come up with a topic for the video, to film it, to edit it. And editing is not just like one process. It has about 2 or 3 rounds that I usually do so that I make sure that only the things that I like, that I want to be there in the video, are there in that video. So I thought it was getting to me, that pressure, and I took a step back, and because of that I was able to work on my short story collection, which was pending since so long that I had almost just given up on that. So taking a step back was definitely a big plus for me, but coming back also feels good. It also feels good to be talking to the camera. As you all know, I am a huge introvert. I don't talk much. And even when I'm filming this video, or any video for that matter, I don't like anybody else to be in that room. I like to be alone when I talk because I make up a lot of bloopers. There are a lot of bloopers, and I am someone who, if that blooper comes out, I don't mind putting it out after it happens, after I've edited them through. But when I get conscious when someone is in the room. So I don't even know where I was going with this. Anyway, the point is that I am back on BookTube and I will be posting regularly from now on. So at this point in time, I really think that I will be able to handle everything that's going on better. I feel like I will be able to do BookTube better. I have a number of other ideas for BookTube that I really want to put it out there for you guys to see and hope that you like it. And I feel like this was a good time to come back and start making videos again. So hopefully this will stay for a while now, and my physical and mental health won't be affected yet again. Though given the circumstances that are going on in the world right now, I don't think that is possible that I will stay unaffected, because every single day I get so angry at whatever is going on in the world. Basically 2020 is one big dumpster fire. It's that's what I realized soon enough, and now it feels like this year is just not going forward, man. Like, it feels like it's going forward at the speed of an express train, but it also feels like it's stagnant and it's not going anywhere and I don't know what to do. So the reason why I thought coming back to BookTube would be a good idea is because, like I mentioned before, my short story collection that I've been working on for a long time, I'm finally released it. I have released it. It is now live. You can find it on Amazon, only on Kindle. It's available only on Kindle at the moment, and sometime in the future I hope that I will be able to make the paperback available as well. That is if Amazon decides to, you know, open Kindle publishing for paperbacks in India as well, which is, it is not available as of now. So I thought let's start with Kindle because I've already done Kindle self-publishing before, because my first short story collection, Five of Hearts, was on Kindle, and I thought this would also be a good way to go ahead. Okay, so I realized that I've been rambling and I need to tell you more about the collection. So the collection is called Nonette and it has 9 short stories, which I feel like the title is apt because Nonette means a group of 9 things in a musical context. So I thought maybe these 9 short stories will make music together, maybe. And I thought that this would be a great name to give my short story collection. Nonette released on June 15th. And the reason I selected June 15th as a release date for this short story collection was because it is a gift to my husband. It's our anniversary. It's our wedding anniversary. It's our 3rd wedding anniversary. And I thought it would be a good, it would be a good gift to give him. And there are 9 short stories, one of which he has no idea that I've written, because he had given me the idea about 5-6 years ago, even before we were a couple. And I remembered somehow that this was an idea that I've never written, and maybe it would be a good surprise for him to, you know, just start reading the book and then find that this story is there. So I included that, and this whole book is an anniversary gift for my husband. There are stories behind these stories, like how I started writing this short story collection. These particular 9 short stories were not going to be part of one collection at one point in time, but I thought these were ready and I really like these stories, the way these stories came out. And I thought it would be a good idea to bring these together and publish them as a collection. The first short story is called Zero, and I wrote this for a competition. I don't remember which competition it was. I think it was the Times of India Write India contest, and I sent it in and it did not get selected. And but I'm really proud of this one because it's something that I have never written before, and I thought that it has that punch that will endear itself to people, that twist. So that's how it made its way into the story. So the next one is A Sojourn Somewhere, and this is a very personal story to me, because in my mind I have so many thoughts going through it every single moment that it gets difficult to compartmentalize it. But there's one thought that, you know, that's like a constant throughout the thread. It's that I really want to travel. At one point in time when I was working in IT, I did not like it at all, which is why I left it at that point in time. So when I think back to my time in IT, I really think that I did a good thing by leaving it. So I imagine myself back when I was a software engineer, and I thought that how would it be if I wrote a story about escaping it? Looking back, I used to be really proud of the story, and I really like how it came out as well. I just hope that if you plan to pick this up, then I hope you will like it as well. The third story is called Mystic. It's horror. And it's surprising that I wrote this horror story because I don't ever go near horror. I'm a huge scaredy cat when it comes to horror stories. I got this idea late at night, I think, one day late at night, and I sat and immediately wrote it down, and I really liked how it went. I myself was spooked at the end, so I thought, okay, I really like how this goes, and I'll make it a short story. So it went into that short story pile. The next short story is the one that I had intended as a surprise for my husband. It's called Dine and Dash. I won't tell you more about it. I wrote this last month itself, and I really like how this came out. I really like how the characters are fleshed out in this story. It's like 8 or 9 pages in Word, and I really enjoyed writing it, and I enjoyed reading it as well. And maybe that's a good thing, not to be narcissistic or something, but I think of the lot, this is my favorite. I mean, it's like asking who your favorite child is or something, but this really is my favorite. And the next story is called Trust the Future. And I wrote this in 2017 December, I remember very well. I was supposed to have submitted it somewhere, but I did submit it and it didn't go through. But I really like how this came out. It's a, like I said, it's political fiction, and I thought it would be a good idea to take things that really happened and concern, I won't say about what, and mix them both and write a political fiction kind of story which will make people think. I don't know how many people have thought about this, but I really enjoyed writing the story, and editing it was a piece of cake, because I didn't find that I wanted to change many things when I was editing it. So that came as a sort of a relief to me. The next one is called Blindside, and I don't know, this one, this has a story behind it, but I really don't want to tell it. I wrote it in 2015, I think, 2015 I wrote this. In a bit to get into a creative writing course. I won't say where, because I'm going to laugh at myself if I do. So I did submit it, and obviously I did not get selected, but I really liked how I wrote the story. Although looking back, I thought that I used unnecessarily big words in the story, so I cut them down, and I kind of like how where it is at the moment. Maybe in future editions I will read back on it and I will think that okay, this is also not needed. But yeah, at the moment I really like where this story is. The next story is called Fight For Me. I have no idea when I wrote this. I really have no idea when I wrote this. It's a completely random story that I wrote, and although I really like this story, it comes really low on my favorite story list in this, among these 9 stories. The next one is Life and Death. It's sort of a contemporary revenge kind of story, and you need to read it to find out what it's about, because I am not going to say what the story is. There's no particular story behind this one, but I just thought it would be a good idea to. I just started writing it one day, and then the story just flowed out of me. I like how it ends though. And the last story is called Crossroads, and I really love this story. This was actually supposed to have been a novel or a novella, but I didn't think it warranted that much of space, and I thought it would be better for me to just make it into a long short story. And I feel like it came out really well, and while editing also the things that I added and I removed, I really enjoyed that process, because it showed me how much I had grown as an author. I wrote this a while ago, so it was pretty obvious that I had done a lot of growing as an author. So those are the 9 short stories that are part of my short story collection, Nonet, which is now live on Amazon. You can buy it for your Kindle. If you don't have a Kindle device, then you can always download a Kindle app on your phone or on your PC and read it. I will leave the link to the book in the description box below if you'd like to go ahead and buy it and read it. And I would love to hear what you have to say about it. It would be great if you could also leave a review on Amazon and Goodreads if you are reading the book and intend to review it. It would be of great help to authors like me that people see what you think about it. And I really, really hope you like it. And yeah, I'm really excited that Nonet is now out in the world and for people to read, and all the people who have been helping me with promoting and marketing and spreading word about the book, a big thank you to every single one of you. Also, I have a Bookstagram tour for Nonet that's happening on Instagram from June 16th to June 29th, where some amazing Bookstagrammers have come forward and accepted and agreed to participate in this tour to spread word about Nonet and to share their thoughts about the book. I will leave the schedule on the screen, and I must thank every single one of you for agreeing to come forward and do this, because it really means a lot. And for every single person that said for you, I'd be more than happy to spread the word about the book. A very big thank you. So what do you think? Would you go and pick Nonet up? Is it something that would interest you? Do you like to read short stories? Is this short story collection something that appeals to you? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. And also let me know if you like this book or not. And as I mentioned before, don't forget to leave a review on Amazon, on Goodreads, and on your social media. It would really, really help authors like me. And yeah, that's about it for this coffee talk. If you like this video, please like it and share to spread the word. And if you like my content and would like to see more from me, don't forget to hit subscribe and click on the bell icon beside the subscribe button to get notified as and when I post new videos. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Until next time, keep reading, keep watching, and add melodrama to your life.